All right, so in today's video, we're going to actually be talking about the healing brush tool. The healing brush tool is the fourth down or one above the clone tool. If you can't see it, it looks like a band-aid. If you can't see it, if you just click on that little down arrow, there's actually four things here that may be visible. And you may actually see the patch tool instead of the healing brush tool. But we want to select today the healing brush tool. Now, in all honesty, I made this image because the healing brush tool is one of these tools. It either works really, really well or it works really horribly. So I made an image that will work both ways to show you the benefits and the drawbacks of it. So what does a healing brush do? Well, it's pretty much similar to the clone tool. So we'll create a layer here. Right click, we'll create the diameter that we want. And I always like the diameter to be a little bit bigger than what I'm trying to cover up. The hardness, again, like the clone tool, I'd like to keep it at zero. And we have a spacing with the healing brush. I keep that around 45%. You can play with it depending upon the size of the image and what you're working on. And then just like the clone tool, you right click, you click an area to sample from, then you move it over top of what you're trying to get rid of, and then you let go, and it will actually clone it in and smooth it out at the same time. And this is where the big benefit of this tool is. It smooths it out. It gets rid of it. You don't have to be exactly right with the color. So if I went down here and sampled something darker, and I went up here and tried getting rid of this, with the clone tool, what you see now is what you would get. It would leave it there. It wouldn't blend it in. It wouldn't do anything to fix it. With the healing brush tool, when I do this and then I let go, it'll try blending it in so it looks better. Now, does it work? It actually works pretty good. You can see here it's just a touch lighter than what it would be in a perfect world, but it works pretty good, a lot better than what the clone tool would in this situation. Likewise, we'll go and get rid of this one. It works fantastic in these situations, in situations where there is nothing around the thing that you're trying to fix. Now, what do I mean something around the thing that you're trying to fix? Well, let's try to go into this one. We're going to select right there. We're going to come down here. We're going to select that. Now, if you look at it, it looks pretty good. I'm going to let go of the mouse, and it actually fixed it up not too bad. We can click here to see. It changed it a little bit, but it's not too bad. Let's try this one here. This one's getting a little bit closer to something. Let's try getting that repair. That one's not too bad. Again, you can see the difference there. It can be definitely repaired better. You can go ahead and try it again, and it will do it a little bit better. And it will work good in this area. We'll get rid of this. It'll look really good. But let's say we want to get rid of this one. Let's zoom in a little bit closer so you can see. Right, so let's say we want to try to get rid of this. Go into our clone tool. We can select a smaller diameter. We'll select where we're sampling from. We'll select this. Now, it'll just blend it in perfectly. Well, it actually did it not too bad. We'll try this one here. We're going to go in, we're going to try blending it in. But all of a sudden, you notice it tried duplicating the fence board as well as the area around it, and it didn't work quite as well. It just wasn't as clean as the previous one. Notice how good this one was? This one's not as good. Now, there's ways to get around it. There's a couple ways. The first way, if you insist on using the healing brush tool, I'm going to create another layer here. You can go in, you can use the marquee tool. You can go in and you can select a border to where you want it to heal. So I don't want it to heal any further outside of this border. I can then go in, select an area. I can then go in and tell it this is the area I want you to fix. And now it'll blend it in, but it ignores what's outside of this area. So it blends in stuff within this border, which makes it so much better than what it tries to do when there is no border there. Let's just create another layer here. Go there. And when I try this, I go in here. I say, okay, that looks really good. And it just didn't do a good job. But here's what I recommend. If it's really close to something like this, instead of creating a rectangular marquee and highlighting and doing all this, this is a perfect time to go back to your clone tool and utilize your clone tool for, well, some of the repairs that you wouldn't do with the healing brush tool. Now I'm just going to go in here and see how close I can get it. That's not bad. We'll get in there and see how much nicer it was. Still not perfect, but it's a lot better than what the healing brush was doing. So when you're doing work, when you're repairing stuff, use the two different tools. The healing brush, like I said, works wonderful in some areas, but in other areas, it just struggles like crazy. So you want to make sure that you're selecting the tool that does the job. Use it where it works well, and then use the clone tool to do the rest of the stuff. So until next time, have yourself a great day. We'll talk to you soon. Get out there, take some amazing pictures, and if you have to fix them, now you know how. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye now.